Hi, Engedi Kids. It's Miss Anna Banana here. I've got my head turned sideways a little bit so that the glare of my glasses doesn't distract you. And also, I think the band is practicing. Do you hear that? It's like the drums. It's kind of fun. Anyway, welcome to Engedi Kids Online, and we're so glad you're here. You know, this is a special month because school started this month, and many of us have been reunited with friends we haven't seen in a while, which is extra special, I think. And also, at Engedi Kids, we're having a virtual block party. And I don't know about you, but when I used to have a block party with my old friends at my old neighborhood in Hudsonville, all the kids and I and the parents would get together and we'd celebrate a birthday or we'd celebrate something special. And it was just really fun. I love block parties. And even though we cannot be together in person right now with Engedi Kids, we can in our hearts, and we can look forward to when we are together. And we're still going to learn about friendship, and we'll get better at being friends as we learn what God has for us. And we're going to learn about a friendship today. Last week we learned about how it's good to have friends. It's good to be connected with others because it makes us better and stronger. And this is the Bible, and we're going to take a story out of the Bible today and learn about a friendship that's extra special. In fact, it was a God-appointed friendship for very good reasons that God had in mind. And I think every friendship is like that, don't you? Each friend that we have that God brings into our lives, or people that God wants for us to be friends with for really good reasons, because friendship is really a wonderful thing. It's one of the best things in life, especially when it's a good friendship, because friendship is when we use our words and our actions to actually show that we care. And if we have friends like that, that means we have people who are acting and caring for us in ways that make us happy and feel loved. I think that's awesome. And I hope you have friends like that. I have some really good friends that I think about right now as I'm talking to you that have been through a lot of stuff that I've been able to help them with. And then I've been through stuff that they've been able to help me with. Today's story is about two friends, David and Jonathan. And it's actually a really special friendship as well, because David was going through some really tough things, and Jonathan had vowed to help him because he was a true friend to David. Jonathan and David. Anyway, I want to go ahead and pray for us and ask God to help us learn what he has for us today, okay? When I get done praying, we're going to do our chant. So I'll see you after that, after the story. And I'll have some thoughts about what we learned about today. God, thank you so much for your love, for your friendship with us through Jesus. Please help us today to learn about how important it is to be a good friend and why we need good friends. Help David and Jonathan's example to us, help their example to spur us on to be the kind of friend to our friends that you want us to be. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. See you after.
Hey kids, we are getting ready to do our Engedi Kids chant. And at Engedi Kids, we know that God created us extra special. Each week, we like to remember that we were created uniquely, on purpose, with a purpose, to love God, serve others, and tell the world. If you already know how to do our emotions, do them with us. We love God because he first loved us. So we say, love God and point up to God. We can serve others to show God's love. So we say, serve others with our hands open and out, like we're giving a gift. Jesus wants to have a relationship with everyone, everywhere. So we say, tell the world and make a circle drawing the world. Got it? Awesome. Let's practice. Love God, serve others, and tell the world. Good. Let's do that one more time. Love God, serve others, and tell the world. Wait a second. I think maybe we can do that louder. Let's try one more. Love God, serve others, and tell the world. Great job, everybody. You did awesome. let's get ready to worship and head into our Bible story.
How do you build a friendship? Some people think it's all about climbing the ladder of popularity or gathering the biggest number of followers on social media. Others believe it means throwing a birthday party at the best place so everyone will want to come, or even laughing along when someone makes a mean joke so that you can fit with the in crowd. But none of those things can promise you real friendship. Building true friendships is not about being in. It's about being the in for others. It's showing someone that you care about them and not just yourself. It's a smile and an encouraging word when someone in your class is having a bad day. It's making a spot at your lunch table for the kid who doesn't have a place to sit. It's inviting a new kid to your birthday party, even if it's just in the backyard. It's taking time to make your own get well card for the kid in your small group who broke his leg. When you choose to be a friend, you create a safe, welcoming place for others. You'll discover you're building true friendships, and others will see God at work in your life. That's why friendship is an amazing way to worship God with your life. Because worship is about more than just singing loud. It's all about living loud.
Wow. I sure do have a lot of friends. I have 2,762 of them. I met this girl in kindergarten and then she moved away after that. And oh, this guy friended me after I gave him my seat on the bus. And I have no idea who this person is. I may have 2,762 friends on here, but I think I really only know like 10 of them. I probably should have thought that through first. Anyway, real friends are people you should really know. So let me introduce myself if we haven't met. I'm Haley, and I'm here to talk to you today about friendship. Friendship is using your words and actions to show others you care. You know how to tell who your real friends are? They show up in person, not just on your phone. They show up when you're happy and when you're having a party. They show up when you need help. They show up when you're sad and you need a shoulder to cry on. Real friends, your best friends, are there for you in the good times and the bad. Just like the two friends in today's story. They went through what every friendship goes through. The highs, the lows, running for your life from an angry king. Oh, okay, well, maybe not every friendship goes through that part.
I wonder if one of my 2,762 friends can fix a broken phone.
Oh, I know, I'll just call someone.
Oh, that's not gonna work.
Haley! I'll be right back.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story. Inspired by the book of 1 Samuel, chapters 18 through 20.
Now imagine for a moment that you're a prince.
It's a pretty cool job.
Your father, King Saul, is a fierce and handsome warrior with a hot temper.
Away from me, you fools!
Saul is the first ever king over the land of Israel. And since you're his son, most people expect you to be the next king. You'll live in a fine palace, wear royal robes, and carry the best weapons. Your name is Jonathan.
Call me John.
You got a great life, right? But then, your dad hires a new guy, a young man your age named David, who's only a shepherd boy. But somehow, through the power of God, David has just defeated the giant Goliath, saving God's people in the battle against the Philistines.
I come against you in the name of the Lord.
Your dad has given David a place to stay in the palace, in a high-ranking army. You and David even become friends. Now imagine, if David fights in every battle and wins, The people of Israel are even more impressed with him than they are with King Saul.
King Saul is like great. Yeah, but have you seen David? He is like awesome sauce.
To top it off, you've heard rumors that David has actually been chosen by God to be the next king of Israel, instead of you. It would be so tempting to be jealous of David, to not talk to him or hang out with him. But that's not who Jonathan was. It's not what Jonathan did. In 1 Samuel, we discovered that instead of being jealous, Jonathan chose to share the best of what he had with his friend.
Here, take my robe. Then people will see how important you are.
Are you sure?
Take my belt, too, and my sword.
But these are all things for a prince.
You're worth it.
Thank you, friend.
King Saul, on the other hand, did become jealous. So jealous that he hurled a spear at David. And later on, he told Jonathan and all of his servants to kill David. Jonathan was horrified. He quickly warned his friend.
Find a place to hide. I'll talk to my father and find out what's going on.
The next morning, Jonathan faced King Saul.
Don't harm David. He's helped you. He put his own life in danger to kill Goliath. The Lord used him to win a great battle. Why would you kill him?
Okay, fine. I'll show you how awesome sauce I am by not putting David to death.
Jonathan and David were relieved. And for a short time, all was well. But then, King Saul went back on his word. He tried to kill David again. And when he failed, he sent other men to try to kill David.
I haven't done anything to your father. Why is he trying to kill me?
He won't do it. He tells me everything, and he hasn't said a word about hurting you.
That's because he knows we're friends, and you would tell me.
This is terrible. I'll do anything I can to help.
So the two friends made a really complicated plan, like something out of a spy movie. Their top secret plot had David hiding instead of showing up for the feast, while Jonathan made up this story to try to find out how angry his dad was. Now, instead of going outside and talking to David about it, Jonathan chose to shoot arrows close afar like a secret message. In the middle of it all, their friendship stays strong.
Whatever happens, please be kind to me. I know the Lord will defeat all your enemies someday, but promise to always be kind to me and to all my family.
I promise.
Shake.
Shake.
The two young men made a promise to stay friends no matter what might happen next. Then, it was time to put their plan into action. When Saul discovered that David was missing, he was filled with rage.
I knew it! You're on his side. That is so not cool. As long as he's alive, you'll never be king.
Why do you want to put him to death? What has he done?
Saul was so angry, he couldn't think clearly. He actually threw a spear at his own son. Jonathan left immediately. And the next morning, he hurried to the place where David was hiding and sent their top secret arrow code message. When David realized things with the king were not good, the two friends ran to meet up one last time.
I'm so sorry. My father.
I know. It's not your fault.
Jonathan and David hugged each other and wept.
Go in peace. In the name of the Lord, we've promised to be friends. He will be a witness between us and our families forever.
There was nothing more to say. David left the city to hide from Saul, and Jonathan went home. Now, Jonathan could have allowed Saul to kill David and maybe become king himself. But instead, Jonathan trusted God and chose to protect and love his friend.
Wouldn't it be cool to have a friendship as strong as David and Jonathan's? Those guys would do anything for each other. Jonathan even risked his life to protect David, but that's what friends do. They love each other no matter what. Okay, not that kind of love. I'm talking about the kind of love this guy Paul wrote about in one of his letters. You can find the letter in your Bible. It's called the Book of 1 Corinthians. You want to know what love is? Here's some of what Paul wrote. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not brag. It is not proud. It does not easily become angry. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It never gives up. Love never fails. That's how you show love to a friend. You're not impatient with them. You don't get angry easily. You protect them and you stand up for them. And you never ever fail. Wait.
love never fails.
That seems kind of difficult. The truth is, for us, it's kind of impossible to love without failing. If you really want to love your friends the way God wants you to love, you're gonna need God's help. After all, he knows more about love than anyone. He loved us so much that he sent his only son, Jesus, to die on a cross for our sins. And with God's help, you can love people more than you could ever do by yourself. So, the one thing to remember today is this. Friends love one another. Sometimes friends fail, but that's okay. Friends also forgive, which is a good thing because this was my friend Erica's phone. And I think she's gonna be like, and I'm gonna be like, and then we'll laugh about it. Because she's a real friend, and so am I. So I'm gonna find a way to get her a new phone. I think I'll show up and tell her in person. I mean, it's not like I'm gonna call her or text her. Okay, goodbye, friends. See you next time.
Jesus, you have been so faithful. Jesus, you have been so true. I will be forever thankful, 'cause I never had a friend like you. Help me to be who you've been to me, to everyone I see. Let us love one another. Valley, you with me on the mountaintop. I'm thankful that you never leave me, and that your love will never stop. Help me to be who you've been to me, to everyone I see. Let us love one another with our love like no other yet. That's the way you love us, God. Thank you for being a friend who's always by my side.
Wow, that was a great story. In fact, it's one of those stories that brings tears to my eyes. David and Jonathan probably had some really good times together as friends. When I think about how they first became friends and how God really blessed them in their friendship, and they made commitments to each other to always be there for each other, I'm pretty sure they didn't realize they were going to go through something as hard as they did with Jonathan's dad, King Saul, trying to kill David. That was pretty tough. You know, friendship, when it's a good friendship, the kind of friendship that David and Jonathan had, it can carry you through really hard times. And what's unique about it too with David and Jonathan is, even though Jonathan was the prince and he could have been like totally awesome and all that, he recognized the special friendship they had that God gave them, but he also recognized what God was doing in his dad, King Saul's life, and in David's life. And he decided to get on board with what God was doing and not to make it about himself. Because technically, he should have been the next king. If you thought about it in a logical way, the way human beings on earth think about kingdoms and... But you know what? God doesn't operate the way we do, and he does not choose those that we think he should choose, the best, the brightest, the greatest to be his leaders and his kings, or presidents or whatever. He sometimes chooses people for other reasons that we don't understand, but in the end, because God's in charge, it ends up being amazing. And God will really help us in our friendships if we make it based on God and his ways. And I want to just encourage you to be a friend to your friends by loving them, showing them through your actions, showing them that you care, even in the hard times, and to choose to be someone who doesn't take things the wrong way or get offended if things don't go your way in your friendship, but instead to just to be loving and kind every time you can towards your friends, and to be there during hard times. I want to pray for us before we get going for the day. And just, I want to ask God to bless you, to be the kind of friend that God wants you to be to your friends. I know for me, when I was your age, in elementary, if you're watching this, you're not in elementary, good for you. If you're in kindergarten through fifth grade, that's what this is all about. But actually, I'd watch it. I love watching kids stuff, because sometimes the best things come out of the mouths of young people and younger kids, and lessons that are meant for younger kids. But anyway, what I was going to say was, when I was in elementary school, I think I was in fifth or sixth grade, actually. I could have been in sixth grade. I'm trying to remember. I actually was really, really struck by reading the Bible one day and realizing that God had given gifts to a lot of people to do a lot of good things. And I could see around me at my church and my kids program, the young people that were with me in the kids program where I grew up. I grew up in Washington State. I thought to myself, man, I don't really have a lot of gifts. Like, some of my friends were really good at singing. Some of my friends were really good at school, like they were really whizzes at math, or they got straight A's. Some of my friends were really beautiful and cool looking, and like everybody liked them, and they were really popular. I was really scraggly and not so, you know, I didn't look like anything special. But you know what? When I was praying about that to God, you know what? I heard him say in my thoughts, he reminded me of something important. He told me that friendship is one of the best gifts you can give to people. And when he said that to me, I felt like he was saying to me that my gift was to be a friend to someone who needed a friend, and to be the kind of friend that Jesus is to us. Isn't that awesome? I get emotional talking about it because I'm like over 50 and I still see God wanting me to be like that even to this day. So remember, it's no small thing to do the small things that God asks you to do. And one of those things is to be loving and kind and show your friend that you care about them, just like Jonathan did with David. All right, let's pray. Dear Father, thank you so much for this lesson. I love it. It's so exciting to see how you protected David and helped him through his friendship with Jonathan. I pray that all of us, Lord, with your Spirit's power in us, would want to be the kind of friend like Jonathan was to David. Help us in our own way and our each unique individual lives to be the kind of friend you want us to be to the kids that are our friends, to the people that are our friends that you've put in our lives for your good reasons and your blessings. I love you, Lord, and I thank you for helping us. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. God bless you guys, and we'll see you next week. Bye.